There's been a lot of fishy activity on the surface lately, like this school of small mack tuna I'm trawling a max rat through. Hooking up right on cue. Yeah. I'm actually targeting the predators that are chasing the mackies. Look, there goes one right now. Wait, what? Let's just wind back there for a second. Let's see that again. Ah, super fish. Moments later, there's an explosion on the surface, and something tells me that this little mackie just doesn't make it. Sadly, neither does my lure. That's kind of how things have been going for me lately. I've had way more hookups than I've had catches recently. It's been a symphony of bust-offs, bite-offs, and spat-out lures. And due to injuring my hand at the start of the year, there's been a few physical challenges, a couple of which I haven't been able to overcome, like this bronze whale shark. It's risky business being a lure in my tackle box. All you can do is soldier on though.
Got a hook up here. It's a reasonable fish. Looks like it could be a mackerel or a tuna of some kind. It's a mackerel. It's a spotty. It's a pretty decent spotty actually. Didn't expect to find a spotty here. This time of year it's starting to get cool.
I was trolling two lures when I hooked this fish, resulting in an ugly tangle of lines as I brought it in.
I'm out here at Jarvis Bay, out near Bowen Island with Paulo, and we're actually chasing kingies, but so far I haven't found any. And I've just spotted a great big mass of fish on the water over here. It looks suspiciously like a big school of Aussie salmon or something like that. Let's have a few casts in there and see what happens. I'm liking my chances of a hookup right here. Yep, big mass of bait fish right underneath you. Watch this. My hook up. Oh, yep, yep, there we go. I'm on. Yep. Yeah. He's feels a lot like an Aussie salmon. These are great fun to catch, these fish. They are great fun. That's one thing I've missed about living further north of here, is the almost total absence of Aussie salmon. They're not the most prized fish out there. A lot of people don't like the taste of them, but geez, they're fun to catch. This guy's taking me on a bit of a ride. There is stacks of bait fish underneath us, Paul. If you want to get some liveys, pull out a jig. Oh yeah. He's an Aussie salmon, all right. Very acrobatic, these fish. Look at that. Oh, they're so much fun. I didn't bring a net. I have got a gaff hook, but I'd rather not use it. I'm gonna release these guys. Come on, mate. Come to Papa. He's not quite ready yet. And I've hooked this guy on a Williamson gyro jig. They're perfect for doing exactly this sort of casting into schools of fish on the surface. Get that ready. Come on up, mate. Relax, mate. You're going back. You're going back. Hooked up a nice fish here. A bloody beauty. And I've got it on a max wrap. A Rapala max wrap trawling along. Oh, these max wraps are good lures. They've been had a lot of hookups on them in the last couple of days. Come on, buddy. That's a tuna. Yep. Mack tuna. Nice fish. He's a survivor though. We'll be going back, won't you, buddy? So relax. Chill out. Relax, mate. Relax. Mack tuna. What a beauty. There you go. Shark bait. Hooked on a ripper fish here. Absolute pearler. He's taking the Rapala max wrap while I was pedaling along. I have every reason to believe that this is a Spanish mackerel. It's up pretty high. Still got a fair bit of line out on me here. Could be a longtail tuna. It's either a Spanish or a tuna longtail. On the Rapala max wrap. Off the surface. It's coming up, it's coming up. It's hanging high. Oh, there it is, there it is. I've still got it. Holy shit. Did you see that? Oh my God, this fish means business, and it is a big tuna. I believe, if not, it's a great big Spanish. I got color there. Wow, this thing is a bruiser. Yep, he's holding down low. He's gaining line on me. Oh, it's a freaking beauty of a fish. Come on, pal, let's get another look at you. He's doing what tuna do. This is gonna be a while. I'm a bit worried about how much line it's taken out on me, especially considering the fact it's going straight down. I'm gonna try and create a bit of angle here. That's a go. Quite sure this is a longtail tuna. It's given me a hell of a fight. We're at least 10 minutes into this, 15 minutes, and it just keeps taking line. And it doesn't seem to be getting tired at all. It just seems to be getting more and more desperate. It nearly bust me off before, and real close. Just letting it tire itself out here. There's not much else I can do. It's coming in towards me. It's below me. It's a long tail and it's freaking huge. That is a big fish. So I've hooked this thing on a Rapala max wrap. Tied on with a suffix fluorocarbon leader and suffix advanced braid line with the gore fiber in it. It's great stuff. And I'm hauling it in on an Akuma Selena 2 5000 hitched on to a Nitro Viper. And this is the favorite of the series. And you can see why. Getting this fish in closer now. It's still very strong. It's still got plenty of energy, but it's definitely tiring out slowly but surely. And now it's just a question of what's gonna tire out first. The fish, me, the line, the leader, the lure. We'll see. The sun's about to go down on us. We get caught out here after dark. Putting in a real effort to get this thing in now, so we're not out here for too long. Oh, it's just huge. That is a big fish. A bloody beauty. Whew. Am I a happy man right now? And as you can see, he's taken that Rapala max right there. Beautiful lure. I've been catching stacks of fish with that lately. What am I gonna do with you? Whoa, he's still plenty strong enough. Look at that there. What a ripper. Oh, you gotta love it.
Yep, the max wrap's shallow diving qualities have made it perfect for trawling for surface feeding fish. But I've been hooking plenty of fish a few feet deeper down as well, mainly using Rapala Magnum Countdown and X-Wrap lures.
hooked up to a great fish here. I trawled over a school of bait fish and my rod went off just as I did. I've hooked it on a Rapala 18 centimeter. It's taken a bit of line on me and it's up high. This is the third or fourth big fish I've hooked today. I've been spat off a couple of times, bit off or bust off by one big fish. And I've hooked this one on a much better rod for these kind of fish. There it is, up at the top, up at the surface. It looks like a longtail tuna. No, it's a Spanish mackerel. And it's a bloody beauty. Yeehaw! Nice fish there. Look at that. He's taking that Rapala real good. I think he's just about ready to come aboard. Yep. You sure are. Ah, look at that for a fish. It's a beauty. It's an absolute ripper. How about that? Spanish mackerel. You've got to love them. That is a good fish. Yeah. Look at that, eh? Yep. The Rapala countdown rules, there's really nothing that they won't catch. I've hooked a pretty big fish here. And when I say fish, I probably mean shark. I'm here in Shark Bay, Woody Head. I just dropped something even bigger. I hooked something a moment ago that was just massive. And I was using a short wire leader and it chomped that off. So I've tied on another lure, another Rapala countdown. And this time I used a longer wire leader and hooked up within about 3 minutes. And I'm on again. I'm liking my chances of getting this in. I'm hoping for a Spanish mackerel, but I'm betting this is a shark. It feels a lot like one. I've got the drag fairly tight actually. The last one nearly spooled me, nearly did it in quick fashion. Feeling more and more like a shark. This is where I often hook them. I've got colour. I can see something. And yep, it's a shark, alright. Let's see how big it is. It doesn't like me very much, I don't think. It got one look at me and said, no, no thanks. I don't like you and your kayak. Ah. decent size. Not quite sure how big he is. Big enough. I've got to be careful here because I'm not that far away from the bommy range and the tide's not that high. It's pretty easy to get caught out and get yourself in a strife. Could be eating flake tonight, I suppose. If I can get this guy in, just not sure how to approach it because I can't grab its tail.
It was found hooked and the lure snagged right in its tail, which is exactly what I was worried about. After fighting the shark for a while, doing my best to keep it clear of the bommy range, eventually I was able to tire it out to the point where I gathered enough courage to get a hold of it and drag it aboard.